Hi, I'm David Gonzalez, and today I want to show you how you can work with stereoscopic media in mistika-review. First of all, we're gonna load the shots. Just right-click on the clip stack in here and select Add Media. Now go to your source folder, this one in this case, and we can see here we have one sequence for the left eye and one sequence for the right eye. As they are clearly labeled, we can just double-click on one of the eyes, and mistika-review will understand it already as a stereo sequence and bring both the eyes, as we can see here with this left and right naming in the clip stack. If you have a different naming convention for stereo shots, you can always modify the rules here in the preferences import. I have a rule for uppercase and another one for lowercase. We're also gonna bring another shot, which in this case is apart from the stereo. It's a VR 360 shot, so double click on it and we see how it is a left and right shot as well. One of the most important things will be the viewing options that we have for stereo, which are up here in the visual editor. You can see one eye or the other. You can watch it in anaglyph. You can watch it in black and white anaglyph, which means that whatever is equal in one eye than the other will get no color. This is a very useful viewing mode for checking disparities between the left and the right eye. If you have a 3D monitor, you can send an interlaced signal to it and you will be able to watch it with your 3D glasses. So let's get back to the black and white anaglyph and bring up the advanced control so that we can see what we can do with the stereo shots. I like to have them covering the bottom of my screen. As with any other shots, we have a clip adjustment, a segment adjustment, and a global adjustment. I'm gonna do some adjustments on the clip. We can modify the convergence of the clip to check disparities maybe on the background, on the foreground, or adjust the viewing so that it's more comfortable if we're looking on a 3D screen. Apart from convergence, we can also modify the floating windows, which is that line that you see on the left. If I show you the left eye only, you will see it more clearly. And floating windows are used to improve the 3D perception of objects that are going outside of the screen and breaking the edge. So if that butterfly goes out of the shot and touches the left edge, we could use a floating window to block it. With these two parameters, we have pretty good control of the 3D shot. And we can also use these parameters on VR. So if we go to black and white anaglyph, we can check the disparities, we can converge to further analyze the quality of the shot. And we also have an extra tool on VR, which is the VR viewing mode. So I can just activate this icon here, the VR goggles, and even in playback, I can move through a shot freely and check the quality of my scene. I hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching.